with 46 criminal cases against him. He is one of several controversial politicians being booed by the BJP. Now, this in an election where public sentiment against corrupt and criminal netas is high. Is the BJP's race to the magic halfway mark being governed by opportunity over principle?
On Thursday, Sushma Swaraj tweeted a public salvo at her party leaders for clearing ties with dodgy leaders, aiming at cleaner politics. Within 24 hours, BJP's Jharkhand unit inducted a Jharkhand Mukti Morcha man with a 46-case-long criminal past, including murder, Kameshwar Baita. There were no tweets from Sushma Swaraj. Baita challenged her call for cleaner politics. BJP evaded answers on Baita, attacked the Congress for fielding leaders facing charges.
अब तो क्रिमिनल केसेस की चर्चा बहुत पुरानी हो गई. तो दिस इज द कांग्रेस कैरेक्टर एंड कांग्रेस शोपीस कैंडिडेट्स पवन बंसल, कलमाड़ी एंड चव्हाण.
Sushma's tweets hasn't stopped controversial congressman Vinod Sharma from getting into the NDA. There is silence in the party on the presence of leaders like Suraj Bhan, who have a criminal past in Paswan's LJP. The BJP is holding talks with Brijbhushan Sharan Singh, accused in Babri demolition case.
This is election season. Ideologies and political loyalties are fast becoming mere expendables. It's open season for political ayarams and gayarams. They are switching loyalties fast and with amazing regularity. The BJP is looking for expansion and Narendra Modi's acceptability, and that is why it is fast becoming the favorite destination.
Friday was a typical day. Ex-Congress and NCP man P. Sangma met Rajnath Singh and discussed seat sharing. Late N.T. Rama Rao's daughter and ex-UPA minister D. Purandeshwari Rao met L.K. Advani and joined the BJP. Expelled JDU man Sushil Singh met Rajnath Singh, joined BJP. The real gain for the BJP came from Tamil Nadu. BJP leaders walked inside the DMDK office in Chennai.
It's a political masterstroke by the BJP that has made actor Vijay Gandh literally the captain of its alliance in the state. The big challenge, will actor Vijay Gandh be able to repeat his earlier magic in assembly polls to strengthen the BJP?
BJP's vote share in Tamil Nadu is 2%, DMDK 10%. DMDK is strong in northern Tamil Nadu. It won 29 seats in the last assembly polls.
DMDK is stronger than you. They have 29 seats. They've also established 10% vote share. Do you think it's going to help BJP in a big way in Tamil Nadu?
Mutually it will help, because Modi ji, fame and name and strong governance, expectation of the strong governance and the base of the percentage of votes from all our alliance partners, including Mr. Vijay Kant's party. Everything will include with the help us.
How many seats is the DMK asking?
Seat sharing, that talks yet to be started.
Top BJP leaders may be celebrating each induction, each alliance, but there could well be a backlash from local netas and ticket aspirants who fear their constituencies are slipping away. With Sam Daniel and Ketki Angre, Rahul Srivastava for NDTV.